I was trying to get it, I live. I want them dead presidents. I want to pull up, head spin. Get it, get fly. I got six jobs. I don't get tired.
Understand, Patricia, you know, invited RhondaK to come by her house today.
Hey, RhondaK. Felt like I was driving to like Mexico or something. It's the country girl. Reminds me of Miami.
Yes, you know I like to decorate.
It is decorated very nice. It's really colorful.
Hold on a second. Okay, that's it.
Yes,
girl.
Not with the jeans.
Girl, is that you?
Uh-huh, that's me.
I thought so.
From Brooklyn to Atlanta. Mm.
Are you serious?
The money baby.
I saw.
The Department of Family and Children Services had been called on Patricia.
Like, I was shocked with the whole Rhonda and the Divaz thing.
Girl.
I was like, what?
I do appreciate RhondaK's honesty to Patricia, letting her know that, you know, she feels like my professional standpoint and my personal standpoint just doesn't match with the person that would be that malicious to call Divaz.
Well, she called me, you know, and she was like, I would not do that. I have children, I'm a mother, and you know, we chopped it up, squashed it up.
So. I'm glad you did, because I don't even know how someone would even just do that. You know, and Mimie is definitely like, Mimie has that strong personality. She's like a go-getter. She's ready to just, let's do it. You know, Rhonda has the same thing where she just like, okay, I got this going on, I got that going on.
Again, my best attribute is being a mother. And I would never, ever, ever do that to anybody. I don't know what happened. I really don't.
And I think that with us all working together, mm-hmm. you know, with all of our qualities and stuff that we all do, we all have different things that we do.
Mm-hmm.
I think we bring all that together. I think most definitely, like, we could just
take off.
Yeah.
Take over.
Yeah.
I'm trying to take over some stuff.
Take over the city, girl. Right. Yes. Yes.
Mm-hmm. All of us have our situations that go wrong with our home. And I didn't think it was appropriate for RhondaK to, you know, make light of the fact that her home air conditioner was broken and that the house was really, really hot.
Yes. I'm gonna get going, girl, because I'm hot and I gotta drive back.
Wow, I appreciate you.
To Atlanta from Mexico, girl, or Miami. I'm in Miami.
Miami, yes.
It was my observation on several different occasions where we went to RhondaK's condo.
Hey, mama, how are you?
It looked very prisonish. The walls were bare white. It had no carpet. It was like you were in prison. Even the furnishing decorative things in the restroom was very not bossy. So I think you need to just really take a closer look at yourself and the different things that you're doing before you cast judgment on someone. I mean, it's not all about, you know, going to the club and shaking your ass, or, you know, if your hair is long or if your eyes are pretty. Yeah. Clean up your own doors first. I am astounded. I'm very happy that Patricia has taken a huge initiative to take steps to further her education.
Oh yeah, so if you look at this chart right here, you see that we have so many more students signing up this month than we did last month.
Hi.
Hey.
What you doing here?
Girl, I'm here doing my thing. How are you?
Good. How are you?
I am wonderful. That's wonderful.
Good. Education is power. Obviously, I'm an educator. I own a career school. I have for the past 12 years, and I do speak Spanish. My Spanish may not be perfect, but one of the things that I have learned about the Latino community is that they're not going to powwow you for speaking bad Spanish. They just appreciate the fact that you put forth some effort to try and communicate with them, if their English is not so good.
Yeah, Rhonda told me, she gave me the information, so I came up here because I need some Spanish classes.
You need some Spanish classes. Yes. I was hoping that somebody was going to at some point come forward and
I do.
Exist.
Yes, I need it.
Yes,
so,
good.
Can y'all help me?
Yeah, would you like to take a seat?
Sure.
And let me get you a brochure.
Okay, thank you.
And I do appreciate that my girlfriend, Mimie, is very interested in helping the other half Latinas to immerse herself more in learning Spanish.
Mama, you take care, okay?
Thank you.
Okay. All righty, good luck.
Thank you.
Okay, you'll still allow me.
Yes.
All right.
Okay, let me show you this brochure we have. Mm-hmm. It's in Spanish.
She does not speak any Spanish. So today, Patricia came over to my school to pay me a visit to inquire more about learning Spanish.
I'm multiracial. I'm Black and Puerto Rican, and I just really want to learn Spanish because I feel like it's just bad that I don't know.
The classes and everything.
Okay, well, great.
Hey!
Rhonda!
Hello!
Hi! You know what? We need to be talking to Tasha, mm-hmm. Keandra, Chris about speaking Spanish.
Yes.
Very, very important.
Mm-hmm.
¿Verdad?
Sí, es muy importante.
I just really thought it was a beautiful thing that Patricia actually showed up at my school today.
Well, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Sí, gracias.
Gracias.
Gracias. You're already on your way.
Yes. Okay, Rhonda. It was nice seeing you.
Absolutely. It was good seeing you, too. Let me hug you.
Okay.
Bye, baby.
Bye.
Thank you so much for coming in. I appreciate it. And talk Keandra and them into getting this done.
I'm going to set something up when we just all do it together because we need it.
An online class would be great. It's real simple. Couple of days a week, you know.
You offer it online, too?
Yeah. You don't have to come to this campus.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's very good.
Okay.
Thank you.
See y'all later.
All right. Bye. Thanks,
nice
Patricia.
Thank you.
I think that she came because I was offering it for free. It's okay. Gratis. Todo bien.
I took the liberty of going over by Roxy because I wanted to do some business with her.
Hello, hello.
Hola, mi amor.
Hola, mamita.
¿Cómo está?
Ay, bien, cansada,
ya tú sabes. Sorpresa,
qué bonito. Sorpresa, ya tú sabes.
Besito.
¿Cómo va todo bien? Dame un besito. Ay,
mua. ¿Y usted?
Oh, Patricia.
Ay, mucho gusto.
Of course, I brought my girl Patricia because I wanted Roxy to see Patricia so Patricia could model some of her clothes or whatever, you know, just trying to, you know,
see. You know, I could see you in it with them long legs.
Yes.
That long hair,
mm-hmm.
You look like you don't care, girl.
Okay.
We could do this. We could rock this show.
I will rock that.
And okay. I can see you in it.
Thank you.
All right, now, let's get you in a fitting room.
Okay. I have the opportunity to partner with some really big names here in the ATL.
Pero mira, tenemos tantas cosas que están pasando, pero hay un show que va a ser bien grande aquí en Georgia.
Okay.
Y lo que ellos quieren es que yo localice unas cuantas gente que tienen, ya tú sabes, la línea de ropa, todo eso tan lindo, y a ver si están interesados en siendo parte del show.
Okay.
Yo sé que en siendo parte del show también vas a ser parte de...
Dinero. Plata.
No lo podemos hacer sin dinero, ya tú sabes.
¿Es todo?
Eso es todo.
Vamos a hacer negocio.
Ok, exactamente.
Okay, chévere.
Y quiero que hables con Patricia también porque como ella hace modelaje también y si necesita modelo, ahí la tiene también.
Okay, ¿y dónde ella trabaja?
Patricia, I was telling her a little bit about you as far as you modeling and, you know, working on Veronica's line, and that if she needs you for anything, that you are more than happy to model anything she has in her store.
Awesome.
Yes. Okay. Gotta plug you in.
Thank you.
I had a conversation with Patricia, and she really didn't like the fact that Mimie is trying to lead her so much in business. Like, she tried to make it seem as though she gave Patricia the plug.
¿Dónde está Veronica?
Veronica ya estaba supuestamente estar aquí.
Veronica, give me one reason why she didn't show up to the meeting.
Veronica.
Hey.
¿A dónde está, mamita? ¿Dónde está? Estamos aquí en la tienda con Roxy.
Oh, yeah. No. Aquí estoy en Miami.
¿Estás en Miami?
Yes. I'm in Miami right now. I'm doing estoy haciendo un photo shoot y vine aquí a una tienda para ver de mi línea de la ropa. To see about getting it in some boutique.
Oh.
I'm in Miami, yeah.
Ok, pues mira, tengo a Roxy aquí para decirle algún momentito.
Hola, Veronica, ¿cómo está?
Hi, Roxy, bien, bien, ¿y tú?
Bien, aquí, esperando a ti.
I don't know, there must have been a miscommunication on the schedule because I told them that I was going to come to Miami. And then I know you and I have been trying to, I know I was, last time you had a prior engagement and now I have this prior engagement.
And my thing is, you know what, some things you just don't do. You know what I'm saying? I could understand that you need this money to make right now, but this is a future opportunity that's going to put your business on deck.
I can't believe we're missing each other again.
Yeah, I guess so. Pues, yeah. Entonces yo no sabía porque es mucho. Eso es, you know, otra vez, back and forth, back and forth. Tú necesito pensar si tú quieres su niña en mi tienda, ¿entiende?
And I just have a lot of stuff going on right now. I have my daughter that I take care of. I have all these modeling gigs. I am traveling back and forth from Miami.
Yeah, whether you're making physical money or you're networking, you're taking time away from somebody else's schedule for that person to plug you in.
Roxy went off the radar.
Entonces, yo no quiero dar una fecha hasta tú estás aquí en Atlanta. Cuando tú llegues aquí, okay. Cuando tú llegues aquí, tú me haces una llamada y tú puedes venir a mi oficina para hablamos con los contratos y todo. Tú me llamas y okay. Vamos a hacer la cita.
Should they do business again? Should they try to meet up again? I don't think Roxy's going to give her that opportunity again.
Entonces, I'll let you go because necesito ir a otra cita. And cuando tú llegues, me haga una llamada, por favor.
Okay, yo te hablo. Muchas gracias.
Okay, cuídate.
Okay, igualmente.
Ciao.
Okay, bye-bye.
I don't want to say I'm not going to help out anymore, but this shit is kind of happening a little bit too much.
One thing I'm going to say when they interviewed me for the Boston News Magazine, massive disciplines equals results. Mm. This girl is not disciplined. She doesn't know what she wants. I don't play that.
Right.
I'm 100% supreme businesswoman.
Yes.
So I'm going to leave it like that.
She's a very, very good person. Very good businesswoman, Rhonda. But her heart is like, oh, okay. You can't give people so many breaks because then something like this big comes up and now look at where we're at.
You know, I, in good faith, you know, gave her a referral, you know, to see my friend Roxy. And I have another really good business friend, Lisa Nicole Cloud.
We all know that name here in the ATL. It's big. Lisa's doing her thing. Absolutely love everything that she has going on here.
And she's got a boutique. I'm just not going to do that. I've already called Lisa and told her, forget about it, you know, cancel the meeting. I'm just not willing to do it. But aside that, even though Veronica has some nice pieces, they aren't equivalent to what Lisa Nicole has in her boutique. I'm sorry, I just can't make the referral, and I'm not going to.
You know, what do you feel?
Your mom's been dying.
And so I was not able to join the girls today at the gym.
Come on, Mimie, let's get
Mimie.
It.
Mimie!
What's up?
Hey, ladies.
Hi.
What's up?
Hi.
You have your eyelashes and shit. Clink, 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 clink. Look at it.
From last night, I didn't want to wash my face. I was so cute.
That's disgusting.
Okay, so I was thinking pole classes.
I think that's lovely.
You down?
Yes.
Mimie, come on.
Are y'all serious?
It's for strength. No, at the, like, whole classes.
Okay, so you mentioned some shit about some shit. What were you saying?
Amateur night.
Amateur night what?
Visit you.
Pole classes?
Amateur night.
Yes.
I'm talking about pole classes. You're talking about really at the strip club.
I'm not playing.
Are you stripping?
Yes.
I did go to a couple of different classes with Patricia, and she actually is pretty good on that pole. That's one of the things of many things that she does very well is she can work that pole. So I guess she was in the gym trying to sweat it out while Mimie was popping her big old behind on that ball.
You don't need to work that.
I'm working the muscles so I don't get any cellulite.
I don't know what exercise that she thought she was doing, but she told me she was celibate. Maybe she thought she was, You know, maybe that was kind of getting her off a little bit, but I thought it was kind of gross.
Like, if you tense your booty, like, all this shit works right here.
One cheek, two cheek, one cheek.
Natalie is 5-10 minutes away.
Oh, Lord. Natalie, what are we going to do with you, honey?
So, Natalie, what's up with you being Miss America?
No!
I'm going to be in a pageant. It's called Miss Georgia Latina. So I'm representing the Dominican Republic and stuff like that.
Natalie, if you're showing up at the gym and you're just dazzling, you look so beautiful. Did you really come to work out? I mean, really. Natalie, did you really come to the gym to work out?
So you don't want to be in the pageant?
No. No, Natalie, we're going to leave that for you.
That's for you, Natalie.
Yeah, that's for you, Natalie.
I see.
Pero, wow. Del gimnasio, vamos a tratar de venir una vez a la semana.
Okay, I'm gonna try.
Okay, no.
I mean, I go.
No trying, do it.
No, but I have to.
Yeah.
I made this referral for her to go and see my girlfriend Erica Mitchell, which is the pageant director for Georgia. And there's all kinds of things going on already, you know. And truth of the matter is when you have a particular walk about yourself, you're going to have that walk and probably a little bit of everything that you do. So I'm really hoping that this situation works out with the Dominican, with the Latin Dominican pageant that she's supposed to be in. But right now it's not looking too good and it's kind of embarrassing. Mm-hmm. Okay, so tonight we're going to Club Dreams and it is a strip club. And our club host tonight is Veronica Noriega, so we're gonna turn up real loud. We have our bottles going on. And Mimi goes totally and completely left on Patricia.
You and I had a conversation where I told you that maybe you shouldn't do business with Tasha if Tasha's right. Gonna fuck you over or not showing up or not calling. You told me specifically out your mouth. Y'all had a meeting with the guy for the building and the monies and all that shit involved, and she didn't call.
No, Mimi is my girl and everything, but she is constantly going after Patricia.
And regardless of whether it was Tasha or who the fuck, Al-Qaeda, whoever the fuck, I told you maybe you shouldn't give her a chance at all, because if somebody fucking show no show and no call, then you shouldn't fuck with them.
It seems like I'm always having to be the middle person, and I don't want to be the middle person.
I'm trying to reestablish your ass where the fuck you're going through. I'm trying to do some business with your ass on a very big motherfucking level. And for you to cross me like that, that's fucked up, bro.
At the end of the day, when Mimi and Tasha were speaking, all Mimi was basically saying was that if, you know, trying to teach Patricia that if somebody stands you up in business, perhaps you should consider not having business with them. And like I said, I love Mimi to death, but if you was coming at me like that chick, we would have an issue, baby. You know, we all grown women and you need to keep your hands out of my face. Oh my Jesus. So Patricia then gets on the pole to dance. Get no fucks, yeah. We don't get no fucks, yeah. Go fill my cup, yeah. Bitch, go fill my cup, yeah. And she was really twerking the pole. But I think she might need to go back and take a few more classes. When she took her skirt off and she was dancing on that pole naked, the dollars start flowing in, honey. Yes. They was throwing those dollar bills at her feet. But they were dollar bills. $1 bills. Wait till I get rid of this cellulite when I jump up on that pole and show them how it's really done. Honey, it ain't gonna be no dollar bills. They're gonna be 50s and 100s and $1,000 bills. They're gonna be like, oh, we're RhondaK. La próxima vez en ATL BossDivas Latinas.
Hello. Hello. I'm Russell Bridges.
You made me a counselor, pleased to meet you.
Welcome to the law office, Richard T. Bridges.
Just to keep the cameras fucking rolling, I don't give a fuck. I ain't being nice, no fucking more.
No, I haven't really missed anyone.
Get it, get fly. I got six jobs. I don't get tired.